In this video, we're going to show you how to pull data from linked records in Airtable into make.com. I do this a lot when I'm creating really complex document automations where I've got a database in Airtable, a bunch of linked records, and I send the data from my primary record to make, and then I pull the data from all of the other linked records into make.com, and then I can kind of supercharge my workflow and create really complex document automations. If you want to learn more about document automations, head over to nocodecollab.com, Document Automation University, check that out. Otherwise, let's get into the tutorial here and show you how you can pull that linked record data into make.com. One quick note, if you've seen any of our previous videos, you might know that there are four primary ways that you can trigger a scripting block from within Airtable. What we are going to talk about now works with all of these methods because we are basically going to be pulling the data through from make.com. So you can use any of these four methods and this will still work. If you want to dive into any of these four methods, check out our YouTube page where we've got more videos that will take you step by step through each of these methods. So here we are inside my base. There's not a lot going on. The concept though is that when I click this button, create card, I'm going to create a trading card for this particular athlete. It's going to have information about not only the athlete, but their team, maybe their position, probably a picture of the mascot and a picture of them. I'm not going to actually build out that document now on this video, but that's the idea. That's what we're thinking. So I have my athlete and I've linked them to a team. I have another video that I will put in the description where I show how to set up the scripting extension so that when you click create card, when you click that button, it sends data to make. What we're gonna do is we're just going to piggyback off of that and take this the next step so that we can start pulling through linked data as well. So if you haven't seen that video or don't know how to set up a scripting extension, check that out. If you have, let's keep going. So I'm gonna jump over to make.com. We can see that I've got two modules. One is just receiving a webhook and the other is getting athlete information. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit create card. What's gonna happen is if I come over here and I hit run once, I've got unprocessed data, I'm gonna use that. And you can see that I got an ID and that pertained to Justin Jefferson, number 18. But you'll see that the team information that came out through was just the ID. So instead of it being the team name or any information about the team, it's just the ID. So the way that we grab the information about the team is very similar to how we grab the information about the athlete. What we're gonna do is we're just gonna add a module. And that module is an Airtable module where we get a record. And now getting a record requires that you have an ID and a base and a table. So I'm going to choose my base is going to be my scripting base. My table is going to be my team's table. And the record ID is going to come from the previous step where I've got an array of all my teams. So this is a ID for that team. And now if I hit run once and I come back and I hit create card, data sent over successfully. And now we can see that I've got my bundles of information that have come through. And I can now see the information is the Vikings. Their name is, team name is the Vikings. The mascot is Ragnar. Their team colors are purple and gold. So my data about my team is now coming through because I was able to just take the IDs and now go get it from another table. So I'm gonna rename this. Let's say get team information. If there was information about colleges or positions or other linked records, all I have to do is add another module, get that record, and I can pull all that information through. So all of those linked records will have IDs on that athlete. So what would come through is I'd have those IDs on my athlete, and then I just pull those kind of those records, that record data through. This works because I only have one team linked. So you can see when I edit my field, I'm not allowing linking to multiple records. I can only have one record. If you have multiple linked records, then you have to use these flow control iterators and aggregators. It's not what we're going to go into today, but just know that if you do have a multiple linked records, you'll need to iterate and aggregate those things together in order to use it downstream for the rest of your workflow. So that is how you pull data through into Make from linked records. You get your primary record. Whatever the linked records are on that primary record will have an ID. And then you just get records. You add modules to get records from all of the different linked records that you want to be pulling through into Make. And then you can downstream do whatever you need to do with that on the other side, whether it's creating a new document or sending to another tool, whatever you need. Hopefully that explanation was helpful and you now understand how you can pull linked record data from Airtable and pull that into Make so that you can do some powerful things inside of your workflow. If you found this video helpful, please like it, subscribe to our channel, and we will see you at the next tutorial.